All right, guys, let's go ahead and unbox the Perrin radiator hoses, upper and lower, in black. Ooh, I forgot that I had this coming. Oh, hell yeah. Thanks, Perrin. Thanks, Mr. Jeff Perrin and Thomas, who's the one who always takes care of me. That's a biggie. That's just a large, huh? That's cool, that's cool. It'll fit me. I can grow into it because I'm obviously growing. Awesome. That is a sweet shirt. I love shirts, as you got, well, maybe you don't know, but I do love shirts, especially in wintertime when I need to wear them. Oh, that's a badass shirt. Thanks, guys. All right, I have about 10 of these. Okay, let's see what we got here. Norton clamps. Nah. Let me check these out. Well, they are sleeve clamps, but you know, nothing personal. I don't like the clamps that come with these a lot of times. And these are way too stiff. I can't even turn them. They are sleeve though. They're not terrible clamps. I just need better clamps. So that's why I purposely ordered some 24s, which I think will be a good size for that. And I have 20s too if they're too big. But these are the Breeze. Now, the gold Breeze are a newer style than the silver Breeze screws. The golds can be a little stiffer, but I can still turn them with my fingers. But the gold Breeze are a little bit stiffer than the silver Breeze screws if you have different types. Ooh, and here we go. Ooh, a 20 might fit on these puppies. Silicone hose, I imagine. Let me go ahead and unbox this and un-saran this thing for you guys. Looks like one, two, three, probably at least four ply, maybe five, but I can't see that fifth ply. But looks like a four-ply silicone is my best guess. Oh, I love that logo. I mean, this will probably get me another like 2.5 horses because the water is gonna flow smoother through this silicone transition and therefore do a better heat transfer and cause overall engine temperatures to drop like at least 0.75 degree. So, you know I'm just messing around, so don't leave a dumb comment like I'm hella stupid. All right, look at that. Nice, nice. Just like the turbo silicone hoses that I've seen, I'm sure this is stronger and more heat resistant. This is like small. Stronger and more heat resistant than the stalkers, of course. Let me just check a size 20, since I can reach them right from where I'm sitting, and see if the 20 is good or the, no. You know what? And the 20s are the BPV clamps that everybody talks about. This is a 20, a Breeze liner, of course. Perfect. So the 20s are too small. So it is these. And of course, when I tighten them down, they're going to be a lot tighter and better. That's interesting that there's not. Wait a minute, 28s. They might have caught something here. Are these 28s or 24s? These say. Wow, you guys just caught me in another Amazon screw up. So they're gonna give me these for free, probably. I ordered, what did I order? Okay, they didn't screw up. I'm just super confused. I did order 28s actually, and that's what these are. I don't think I saw a 24 is why. So it was either 20, which is too small, or 28, which is a little bigger. And, you know, I might use these, dude. These are good clamps, especially because they're liners, and they're the best size. I may end up using Perrin clamps in this case. We'll see what happens. All right, let me just, God, I'm wasting too much time. I won't unwrap this on camera. I did get some cooling tape for the lower hose I might think about using. I don't want to reuse that matting stuff that I already put on the stock hose. It won't stick again. This cooling tape is really good for hoses and things because it has a lot of flexibility to it. All right, let me bring in the car. I think I'll do ramps and for ease of accessibility, and I'll start draining. You don't want your car hot when you drain it because your thermostat will be open and your engine will be open. The thermostat door will be open, right? So the coolant's all one. You drain it from the radiator. All the coolant comes out the radiator and out the engine because the door is open. Then the car sits there for an hour while you work on it. The thermostat closes up and closes the door. Later, you fill the radiator. It can't get in the door, into the engine. And that is where you risk head gaskets and overheating, because you have to get the temp hot enough to open that door. And the catch 22, that there's no coolant on the other side of the door, so the engine's getting hot until the door opens, lets the coolant in. Bottom line, I'd change your hoses when your car is pretty cold, and then you're safe. The door's closed, and the door's closed in both sessions. And you're not going to lose that engine coolant and risk a little bit of overheating. I do have two super coolants here. I'm going to just replace the... I was going to reuse it, but I said, why bother? I got 25,000 miles. I'll just spend a little money on Subaru coolant and replace it fresh since I'm going to drain it anyway. All right, guys. I'll probably sweat through this shirt in about 10 minutes, but hey, I'll call it a break-in. I'll try not to get it too dirty before I wash it. All right, car's up in the air. The upper hose won't need anything moved. There's no sense in wasting time or moving anything. It's 100% accessible. So for the bottom, first thing I'm doing is removing the plastic tray. You know how to do that, a 12 and a screwdriver. All right. Now, let's see. Let me get you a better angle. Hold on. All right, guys. Again, super easy to access. I can even do this one. I don't need to do anything else here. This should be a really easy job. Now, you can see I do have a wrap here, but this was on the metal pipe itself, so the hose starts at my finger. So the hose will come off, and this wrap will, of course, stay. It might as well stay, and it'll just keep a little more heat there, keep it a little better. Let's see. I'll wait until I get the stock hoses out to compare the shapes and stuff like that. This one is kind of big. That doesn't look right. Let's see. Maybe that's the other hose. Let's see. Is it this one? Must be, something or other about this one. I don't know, it's tricky. I'll figure it out. There it is. Yeah. There it is. And actually, it does look pretty dang good. It should be the same size, and it looks like it is. So that's pretty awesome there. All right, now probably what most of you want to know is how the hell do you drain it. I of course I can undo the hoses, but I saw, like, I don't know if that thing right there is a drain or not. I guess I could try and find out. That might be a little hex screw there thing that drains it. I'm gonna remove this metal tray here just because I want full access. All right, I do feel like it's a pretty good chance that's the drain, because there are no other things anywhere except this weird little thing right there. Now maybe it has a seal. I'm gonna try very carefully to unscrew it. If it doesn't want to budge too easily, I'll just pop the hose and be done with it. But I want to see if this is a drain or not. I don't think that's a drain. Okay, that's not a drain. Thank God it wasn't a hole and I'd destroy my radiator. All right, I could probably look in the service manual, but, oh, dang it. It was hidden behind this thing, guys. God damn it. Okay, no big deal, no big deal. Here is your drain. Of course, you learn again from me, and I screw up my car for you guys. Nah, I mean, it's not screwed up. It's fine. But your screwdriver, dang it, wish I'd seen that. Okay, let's go ahead and drain it. Lesson learned, ha ha ha, you can all laugh. This is probably gonna shoot out. Uh-oh. I'm gonna move to the hand action. Ugh. And then my cap is still on, so, oh, good. It's barely gonna drain at all because the cap's on. Here's your little plug. And I will undo the cap in a minute. Man, that's embarrassing. It got the wrong drain, oh well. That's why this is Last Human's Garage. That's why this is real life. You see that not everybody is perfect. All right, let's go ahead and, I don't think it's under pressure. Let me very carefully with my extra finger. I'm still holding it, see? Don't let it go fully until you're sure it's not gonna spray. Wiggle it, make sure you got all the air. I'll leave that for a minute. Just to let it relieve a little pressure, right? All right, not too bad, not too bad. Now there's gotta be a lot more than that. I will go ahead with the next pressure relief. Whoa, it's really starting to splash now. Okay. Yeah, now it's pouring a little better. All right. That's it. Draining, it's gonna be that quick. Hopefully my hoses go on in like 10 minutes. And hopefully it's everything's as easy as it looks. Now the coolant you can see is super clear and nice, but I'm gonna replace it anyway. All right, I know the upper hose will be ready. That's not really gonna work. I like to use my spark plug pliers for these type of things sometimes, but they're a little bit not right, so let me get some pliers. All right, if you don't wanna fight with these, just get a mama jamas, and just take care of it in one shot. You get a small pliers, it'll be slipping off, won't be strong enough. That's gonna be a two-hander so I can pull it from underneath, so I'll be right back. Now these hoses have been on for 25,000 miles. Don't go just start twisting it. This is probably like sealed. You gotta do your release underneath and release all that pressure and any buildup or corrosion before you start twisting to make sure you don't damage your neck. See, there we go. I just loosened it a little with the screwdriver, so that one's good to go. It's kind of a hard angle here, but I can probably just a little bit, you know. You just want to like break the seal, you know, like when you're drinking beer and you break the seal. Just like takes some of the, oh, be careful with my dipstick. One of my buddies' dipstick snapped off in their oil pan a couple weeks ago. And he's on our team. You probably know him. Okay. Think I got those. Yeah, that's loosened up. I'm just afraid it'll still drip. For extra safety, I might put a towel under it, you know, just so I don't get coolant all over anything. The extra drips that are probably still in there. There might be. Let's see if I can lift it up, cause a waterfall, get it to drain out, something like that. Okay. Not bad, not bad. Zero issues with this. It's not really worth cleaning. It looks thicker, but it's still smooth. That little corrosion there. It looks like a nice stainless steel piece right there. It looks like stainless steel at least. I don't know if it is. Okay, so ready to put on the top hose. It was that simple. I mean, I literally been here like 10 minutes for this entire job. All right, check out the fitments and the accuracy. Pretty freaking good. 101% perfect. That's pretty good. I've seen a lot of aftermarket hoses, particularly turbo hoses, on other cars, not on Subarus, where the aftermarket silicones were like a quarter inch off here and there, the angles were off. This is, as I expected with Perrin, it's the most accurate parts you can buy. That is like really, really accurate matching. All right, let me get the clamps ready. Let's move on. Away. All right, I got the clamps set up. The only real place I can see to put them is toward the, on the top. Hopefully it won't interfere with anything. I really doubt it. And this one fits right here, not in any contact with the dipstick and stuff like that. So we'll see how this fits. I'll probably straighten it out a little bit, get it more flat. It looks kind of crooked right there. I got the clamps off. Now I'll just use like a hook tool kind of thing to work my way around the edges again and just loosen it up before I try and yank it off. All right, there is still a lot of water in here after you put the plug in. So don't just yank this off and think we're all good and empty. So I very carefully remove it, because if I open this, it would probably gush all over my shorts. So I have to just keep doing this until it stops draining, obviously, without opening it too much and making a mess. So I'll be back in a bit. Okay, now the lower hose is finally empty. And the other half came off real easy here. I just got to get the clamp off that metal over there. I went backwards to give myself room. Then we'll go ahead and probably wrap this Perrin hose first, and then we'll get it installed. Let's do another matchy match. Looks like it wouldn't go. I always test it both ways. Nah, that's it. Good match. Maybe a little bit extra on each Perrin side, which I always enjoy, a little extra to be safe. That's pretty much it. All right, let's see what's next. All right, guys. I don't know if I said that twice or not. I'm going to not wrap this. Someone mentioned it once, and in all my almost 3 years of 2015 plus study, I've never heard one person ever melting a hose or blowing a hose next to the J-pipe. So, and it'll really ruin the look. Not that looks matter, but hey, OCD, it's a nice looking hose. So I can always wrap it later. I do have some DEI carbon, titanium 15-foot, 2-inch wide wrap for the pipe that I'm considering doing. And I can always go that direction instead and not touch the hose. But the question on that is, I'm sure a bunch of you guys probably know, I was going to use plastic zip ties. I just can't imagine a zip tie ever straight up melting. But of course I know they always say use metal zip ties, but has anybody ever honestly seen a zip tie melt and pop off on these things when you wrap your exhaust? I mean, I guess there's a reason they make metal ones, but I just can't think that it's going to get hot enough to melt a zip tie. So tell me about that. Tell me if I should just wait and make sure I get metal zip ties. Do it right, you know. And of course, I'm not going to wrap the cat. I probably wrap from here to wherever, how much material I have, maybe to here, maybe even to the end, but probably not. But I don't want to wrap anything from here forward, especially the cat. Now, I do believe some of the rumors about cats getting a little too hot when you wrap them, so I don't want to go that far. You can also provide some opinions on that if you want. All right, let me get the clamps and get this hose done. Almost done, I guess. Another tip on the hoses is to lube them up a little bit to get that last eighth of an inch, because twice now I can't get the last eighth of an inch if I didn't lube it, and then I had to take it off. So it's just so tight and snug that just spray a little lube on it on both sides, and then it'll push on all the way 100%. One more clamp and I'm ready to fill. All right, let's see here. Where's my other blanket? There it is. Just in case I splash anywhere. Gotta let it drip down. Now, when I turn on the car, when this is nice and full, I'm gonna go ahead and turn the heater on full to open any heater doors, hopefully, and flaps, just to allow the best flow of coolant possible. This may kind of let it enter in the back door, so to speak, if you do have a closed thermostat, as it's like a loopy kind of system. So always have your heat on full blast, which will open all the heater valves and vents, just to try and get the coolant spread out everywhere it can. See, I could fill up the funnel, and then it just empties as it starts filling up all those fins and holes. Don't want to go too fast, or I might get a little overflow. Anyway, I'll be right back. All right, guys. Oh, figures. First gallon of coolant is empty. Still looks like I can add more, I hope. I'm sure I have more than a gallon in this bucket. So I'm sure you all want to know how much came out. That's what I'd want to know. Looks to me about a gallon and a half, so I'll just start out. I'll be right back. I'm going to fill this bucket with used, and we'll see how much is left for the next bucket. All right. Got that full of used old coolant. It took almost the whole bucket. So there is only maybe 1.25 gallon. Still, you're kind of stuck. You're kind of screwed where you can't just buy 1 gallon. I'd buy two like I did, and I'm going to have a lot of extra later. But 1 gallon almost holds all the coolant that came out. Tricky trick, 1 gallon. So now you can see. Whoa, nut slip. Now you can see exactly how much coolant came out. Damn it, wouldn't you freaking figure that the label gets in the way? Right there. Okay. Right about more than half. So you got 1.5 gallons right there that came out. A little bit extra. And lastly, I start the car and I just kind of watch for little bubbles here and there. Be careful of the fans. Squeeze your hoses a little. And you could try to, where is it? Very tiny, tiny bit, pour a little more, but you're probably gonna make a mess because it was already full. That is full. Let it spin up, and then your most important thing here, every minute or two do a spot check on your temperature gauge, make sure it's not pegged, which would mean the engine block is low on coolant, as I had talked about earlier. Very, very unlikely. I had it happen one time in my 25 to 30 years of doing this job, and when I was at a shop, and it was because the Honda had a bleeder valve that you're supposed to open to let the air fill up the engine. I didn't do that, and I was 18 or something. So it's just always in the back of my mind. Make sure that your temperature is not spiked. Now's a good time to check. No, I'm sure it's fine. I mean, it's super unlikely these days on these kind of cars to have that issue. But if all of a sudden it went to the high red mark, then you kind of go, whoa, you shut it down and you figure out your air problem. But it looks like it's probably fine. I'm just about done. I'll turn this off. I forgot to mention one thing. You're kind of playing a a game of chicken with this, because as it heats up, it's going to be rising. So you want to keep pouring in, but when it gets full, as it heats up, it's going to rise, and suddenly you reach the point of no return, and it'll start spilling. It'll get higher instead of lower, and you won't be able to get your cap on without dumping it all out, shoving it all out of the way. So you also don't want to overfill it, because it is expanding the whole time it's heating up. Looks like we're doing real good. I think this was a success. Thanks a lot to Perrin for sending me yet another mod. This car is almost all Perrin. All the time, all Perrin, all the time, all Perrin, all the time. All right, thanks for watching, guys. I know I haven't seen too many posts about this mod. Let me carefully, no leaks. I mean, I'll check it, you know, tomorrow, make sure. But when I do hose clamps, I use socket, not screwdriver. Just be careful you don't overdo it and make it slip. But a socket, it's always tight enough. I don't see any drips aside from the little spill I made. So that's the end of this video. Look for a new Perrin mod coming on the Forester XT pretty soon. If you're on Instagram, you already know what it is. And I keep forgetting details. Exactly a gallon and a half, just like expected. Yeah, I can't see it. Exactly a gallon and a half is what you're gonna lose. So you gotta buy 2 gallons if you wanna do your coolant. And this isn't even 100% flush, as you know. It probably has twice the coolant in there. This is just a radiator drain, and it'll mix with the old stuff. 80% of everybody does it this way. If you want a complete flush, it's a much, much bigger pain in the butt. All right, guys. Most importantly, these are, I think, 90 on the site. I can't remember if that was a crossed off on sale number or not. Don't forget Last Humans Garage coupon code at perrinperformance.com. 10% off, even if they're on sale. That's another 10% from Last Humans Garage. So you can get these cheaper than they sell them on the site if you're interested. Last Humans Garage.